Let's call a spade a spade. Chairman, you are just a burial committee chair of the other day. Keep quiet. This committee has been in existence for the last 8 years. You've just become a chairman the other day. Mr. Speaker, it is in my view, and urge members, we reject this list, so that we have representation from other members who have not served in this committee, Mr. Speaker, so that Honorable Bokose can get an opportunity to take some development projects to his constituents, Mr. Speaker. Honorable Maoka Maore can have, if we are going to have the 27 members who have been there, Mr. Speaker, we want to know from the committee the list of projects that have gone to those 27 constituents, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, let us be fair. We must be, the fairness must begin in this house, Mr. Speaker. It can't begin outside the house, Mr. Speaker. So, Mr. Speaker, I am pleading with the members that we should not allow this, because the last parliament refused it. This parliament also must reject it, Mr. Speaker, and let us have other members. If you have served a 3 years term in that committee, please give way to another member. Please. This is not a committee that was formed for you, Mr. Speaker. With those fears, Mr. Speaker, I am urging our members here to support me in rejecting the ones, the members who are there, who have performed very well, whom we need the expertise, like my chair, my leader here, who is a senior accountant in this country, maybe some lawyers who can help them in law, like Milly Odhiambo. We can discuss at the level of party. But, Mr. Speaker, we cannot have members who have served for 3 good years. Some of them have benefited from projects through that committee, Mr. Speaker, of enormous amount, Mr. Speaker. Kindly, these other members also are elected like you. They need to take care of their constituencies. They need to participate in the sharing of the national cake, because they also represent people. They don't represent cows, Mr. Speaker. So, Mr. Speaker, I'm urging you, I'm urging members here, this list must go down. Thank you so much, Mr. Speaker.
Honorable John Bandi.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it's very untidy for me to respond to my whip. Because again, my whip is, I think I've never had a very good working relationship with anyone like I do have with my whip. Ideally, or ordinarily, it was a whip who should have forwarded the names, but because of some other commitments, in fact, I had to leave Homa Bay to come. Actually, the leader of majority called me that I need to be here. I was supposed to be in Homa Bay for a very important function of the Catholic Church, but I had to leave home to come and sign off this list because my whip was engaged elsewhere. And I actually shared with him after, in the spirit of disclosure, I actually shared with him after this. And, well, he did have problem with one or two names I'm not going to mention, but we agreed that since I'd already reappointed the same members, it would be okay. Mr. Speaker, I just want to caution that let us not scandalize ourselves, because really when it comes to committees and people using committees to lobby for funding for their constituents, it happens every day. I've been in the Public Accounts Committee, Mr. Speaker, and I will tell you that at that time, we got funding from the Ministry of Education. And there's nothing really wrong with that, because the money went to the schools in my constituency and the rest of the members of Public Accounts Committee. In the Committee of Transport, I know that out of the fuel levy fund, there's some allocation that goes to those members of those committees. And there's nothing really wrong, because this is a discretion of the Cabinet Secretary for Transport. Now, when it comes to budget, if there is any committee, Mr. Speaker, I wish the members could listen to me. If there is any committee that cannot put any money without this House knowing, then it is the Budget Committee. Because every report of the Budget Committee, including the Appropriations Bill, passes through here. So, Mr. Speaker, I just want to caution ourselves. Let us not feel incited. If you look at the membership of this committee, some members have just been appointed to this committee last year when we made changes to the committee, like Honorable Kanini Kega, there is Honorable Fatuma, no, Fatuma has been there. Malimo has not been there. Emmanuel Wangwe has not been there. The Honorable Atandi, Honorable Atandi is new. Honorable Sakwa Binyasi was not there before. Honorable Sakwa Binyasi came in last year. We removed him from Public Accounts Committee to this committee. So, Mr. Speaker, I know some of the members, like myself, have been in this committee for long. And by the way, this is the only committee where I sit, the substantive committee. So, and then like Honorable Milly Odhiambo, only sits in one committee. Mr. Speaker, I want to just persuade my friend and whip that please just allow this to go on, proceed, so that we don't appear like fighting ourselves.